Welcome back. The northeastern state of Meghalaya is going to polls in the first phase on 11th of April. Now, Meghalaya has two Lok Sabha seats, Shillong and Tura. Both the Lok Sabha seats in the state are reserved for the members of the scheduled tribes. This year, the BJP has fielded Sanbor Sholai from Shillong. And on the other hand, Congress's Vincent H. Pala will be fighting. Our correspondent, Afrida Rehman Ali, gets us the pulse of the voter in Shillong.
My opinion is that in this election, that who's capable for this, for our youngster who is having this problem of unemployment. So we are looking forward to hope for the best for this Lok Sabha election, that more employment for our youngster.
Some of them have been fulfilled. I won't say everything has been done, but then, yeah, I feel like quite have been done.
What I feel is in Shillong, no political parties does any work. It seems like everybody is sleeping.
Okay.
But still, we will definitely vote.
We are in Shillong, the capital city of Meghalaya. Now, here is going to be a very interesting two-way contest between the Meghalaya Democratic Alliance and the Congress Party. In fact, the two seats, Shillong and Tura, both present a very tough contest. In Tura, for instance, Agatha Sangma, daughter of former Lok Sabha Speaker Purna Sangma, is pitted against former Chief Minister of Meghalaya, Mukul Sangma. In Shillong as well, a very strong candidate of the Congress Party, Vincent Pala, is in the fray. The interesting thing here is that the BJP, despite being part of the MDA, the Meghalaya Democratic Alliance, which is led by the National People's Party, the NPP, has fielded candidates of its own in both these constituencies. So in some sense, it could be a three-way contest as well.
In 2014, there were just 61 women MPs in the Lok Sabha. One of these seats was Guwahati, which looks all set to send its third woman MP to the lower house. Afrida Rehman Ali joined two women leaders in Guwahati who are vying to represent the capital of the largest state in the northeast.
We are in Hajo in the Guwahati constituency of Assam. This is a very prestigious seat, being the state capital, and BJP has fielded a woman candidate. We will be tracking Queen Ocha during her campaign trail.
Guwahati is one seat that is almost certain to have a woman representative in parliament. Former Mayor Queen Ocha of the BJP versus TV host and film personality of Assam, Bobita Sharma of Congress. Formerly with AGP, Queen Ocha started politics in early 80s during the Assam agitation. Now actively campaigning across Guwahati, she's banking on the strong image of Prime Minister Modi.
Mera dal ka party ka jo hai organization ka itna mazboot hai grassroots se upar tak aaj sabse mazboot mera booth sabse mazboot wahi mantra leke hum log aage badh rahe hain.
The main challenger for the BJP candidate of Queen Ocha is Bobita Sharma, the Congress candidate from the Guwahati constituency. She is addressing a rally there right behind me. The important thing is that the last two times in the Lok Sabha elections, Guwahati has sent a BJP candidate. Will Bobita Sharma be able to break that pattern?
Bobita pitches her campaign on what she says are the failed promises of Prime Minister Modi, talking about the futility of Achhe Din and the threat that the Citizenship Amendment Bill poses.
Amar poriyalor lok asil, Bangladeshor lok asil, Rajasthanor lok asil, Biharor lok asil, sokolobur asil Bharatiya Nagori.
If this is not the final shape of the bill, why did they pass it in Lok Sabha? I want to ask them that question. Why did they pass it if it's not the final shape? They are just lying through their teeth, and people of Assam are not fools. They are against the people of Assam, against preservation of our identity, our culture and our language.
A former lecturer and social worker, Bobita is considered a political novice compared to Queen Ocha, who has been a grassroots leader and a veteran in politics. Experts say this contest could go either way.
But for the first time, you at least get two very major political parties, both in the very seminal Guwahati Lok Sabha seat, sending out two veteran women politicians, and both Babita Horma from the INC and Queen Ojha from BJP are actually both veteran politicians. I think we are going to watch some excitement here.
With an electorate of over 19 lakh, the city's 4 lakh Muslims could be the decisive factor. Barring once, the seat has been held by the BJP in each of the last 4 Lok Sabha polls. While it may not be clear who will win this one, one thing is certain. Guwahati looks set to elect its third woman MP. With video journalist Sachin Yeram and with Afrida Rahman Ali, Tonima Biswas for Mirror Now.